Yes, I was informed by the Senate President last night after our kumustahan in Pampanga, no, that the OSAA people, yung security, Senate security people, are in Davao, and they were about to fly back to Manila with the siblings, Dargani siblings. And that's good, no? And sabi ko nga, yung si Major General Rene Samonte, yung Sergeant at Arms namin, deserves commendations from the senators and the Filipino people as well, no? Because, you know, had the Dargani siblings flown outside of the Philippines, wala na, no? Parang putol na rin tayo. Mm-hmm. So what I can say about this is there is no safe haven on earth, no? Even for people like Michael Yang, Christopher Lau, Dargani siblings, Davao City is not safe. They should stop thinking na hindi sila pwedeng magalaw doon. No? Mm-hmm. As a matter of fact, as was proven last night or late afternoon yesterday, they're now in the Senate premises and they will be forced, no? Sabi na, gamit tayo yung word na force, to attend the November 25 Blue Ribbon Committee hearing.
No. But then, what about Michael Yang? He seems to be an untouchable so far.
Well, so far. You said it right, so far. Mm-hmm. But, you know, our people here in the Senate are not sleeping on their job. No? Of course, he'll be more careful this time after the arrest of the Dargani siblings, and so is Christopher Lau. Because both of them have already been cited in contempt of the Senate, of the committee, and have warrants of arrest against their persons.
No,